We are at mixed media, skill level E, so we're getting really good at what we're doing, and we have some lovely band music in the background. Let's get started. Okay, so at this level, we are actually going to do authentic mixed media, which means we are going to make a plan where we have just a bunch of supplies. Who knows what we have available to us? And we are going to make art using three different kinds of supplies. We are going to make art that uses two different techniques, so two entirely different ways to work with the material. We are going to attach everything cleanly and neatly, so even though we are gluing down, everything is going to be nice, clean, and crisp. We are going to attach pieces so that they don't fall off, and we are going to use a pattern and texture to create art. So kind of it's going to be more organic or more unrealistic with our work. It would be called abstract in the art world. Okay, let's go to our sketchbooks, and in our sketchbooks, we're going to go ahead and write our name. Our name. Once we've written our name, we're going to circle mixed media. Ooh, my pencil's not showing up very well. And then we are at skill level E, so we are writing an E. Then we are going to do number one, which is create our plan, which means we need to dive in and see what type of resources do we have available. Whatever we have, it's time to start experimenting. And the easiest way to experiment is to grab yourself a pair of scissors and to get yourself some glue. And then what you're going to do is you're just going to take your supplies, whatever you have. It might be this, it might be something entirely different. And you're going to ask yourself, how do I make this not what it is? That's the secret. How do I make this not what it is? So let's just do what's some investigative work I can do. Well, look, I can cut them. I can make kind of weird shapes that way. I could cut them, but not cut them completely. And look, I could probably make something that's 3D, right? Maybe that's almost like flower-like, or it's like texture that sticks up. So maybe this part here gets glued down and all this gets stuck up. Maybe I do two more of them. I am gonna just play and explore, and all of that play and explore is going to go kind of in a little section right here. I wanna figure things out, like how much glue does it take to hold things down? If I put this here and I make my little dot and I try and squeeze this in place, it doesn't do anything 3D. So I have to play and explore. Maybe what I have to do is hold these up. Maybe I have to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh, well, that works kind of well, but maybe I'm gonna have to add more. So I just play and explore until I start to think I've got an idea. Once I've done that, I'm gonna go ahead and create a plan. I wanna keep it pretty simple. So maybe my plan is going to be that I'm gonna do a red circle and I'm gonna have all this fun stuff here. Maybe I'm gonna put, I happen to have at this particular center, maybe I'm gonna put a bell in the center. And again, I'd have to figure out what kind of glue, what do I need to attach that bell? And then maybe I'm gonna take, I have this random sparkle paper, I'm gonna do random sparkle paper here. So I'm gonna do sparkles. Whatever plan I come up with, so Miss Russ happens to have already done one, is gonna go in this space, voila, down here at the bottom. Okay, so this is what Miss Russ came up with. I played and explored, I glued a little down. I didn't have to glue all my play and explore, but I glued some. I came up with a plan, but as I was working, I realized my plan was way too complicated, so I simplified it. Notice how clean all my things are glued down. Notice I have one technique of just gluing the pieces down. I have another one where I did some cutting so that it became 3D and textured. I did another technique where I overlapped. I did another where I overlapped again, but this time I shredded the little pieces and I had to use layers. See how mine is like actually 3D on the paper. Okay. Make sure that you take time to look at your skill sheet on this one and that you conquer everything it lists. As always, happy art making. Bye!